CNN counterterrorism analyst Phil Mudd, as well as our CNN military analyst Colonel Rick Francona and General Mark Hertling. Rick, if I could start with you. 56 days into the U.S.-led bombing campaign over Iraq, 10 days into the campaign over Syria, no ground presence at this point. Is it unrealistic to expect that that campaign should have made a difference, one, with pushing back ISIS fighters right across the border inside Turkey there, surrounding that city of Kobani, but also just in the behavior here? You have ISIS still showing its power and its brutality of continuing to behead Western hostages. Is it too early to expect difference?
There's two things there. Looking at the whole air campaign, it's not just focused on this one town. Right. They're ranging targets all the way from the southwest of Baghdad all the way over to Aleppo. So there's it's a wide area, and there really aren't that many aircraft participating. It looks like a lot of countries on paper. But when you look at how many aircraft are actually participating in any given moment, it's really not that big of a campaign. So to expect that we could turn back ISIS in this one town, this one battle, is a little bit unrealistic, especially when there's no boots on the ground, no troops on the ground to positively control these airstrikes. You cannot drop bombs on troops that are fighting unless you've got somebody there to accurately do that. Now, on to the second point of that, has this not changed the behavior? I think that maybe the bombing may have accelerated some of this behavior because ISIS feels that it needs to make the point that they're still fighting, they're
show
still
their
relevant.
Power.
Exactly.
Punish the U.S.,
and punish
Britain. And
punish the West for what they're doing.
General Hertling, it raises a question. If there aren't many aircraft involved, as Colonel Francona mentions, should there be more? Because I've been watching the pace of these strikes over the last several days. It'll be one a day around the area of Kobani, for instance, maybe half a dozen in Iraq and Syria. There were none in the last 24 hours. Should there be more? Should there be a higher pace of activity so that they could push the fighters back, have a greater effect on the ground?
Well, what I'd say, Jim, is we're stretched pretty thin all around the world. I mean, this has been an effort, certainly a priority effort in Iraq and Syria. We've done some very good work in Iraq, as Rick just mentioned. The strikes have been effective, but I also think we ought to talk to the American people about whenever you have one airstrike, whenever you have one bomb dropped, there are multiple aircraft supporting that one bomb drop. There are jammers, there are fuelers, there are intelligence planes, and I think you're gathering intelligence while you're striking the targets at the same time.
But the quality of the targets, because again, I'm watching the list of things that are hit every day. It's a tank there, it's an armored vehicle here, it's a fuel depot there. It doesn't seem like the quality of targets is where you would expect here, and this gets into, I think we have to prepare the Americans and others watching this program for a long campaign without immediate effect.
Yeah, we have been attempting to say that for a very long time, Jim, as you well know. This is going to be a long campaign, and I would push back a little bit in saying that some strategic targets have actually been hit. There are numerous reports. Some have not reached the Western media in terms of main headquarters, if you will, of meeting places of Khorasan, Nusra, and ISIS in Syria being struck. Some of those don't get out because we don't have the immediate assessment that's releasable to the press. But I think some of those targets are actually being hit, as well as what Rick said a minute ago about the priority effort is going against the targets in Iraq itself, and Syria is a secondary effort right
well,
now.
Well, Phil, let me ask you this. You know, these videos appear to be shot out in the open desert. One asset that the U.S. and the coalition has now is that they are flying surveillance flights, both drones and manned surveillance flights over Syria and over Iraq, where ISIS has these positions. Would those flights gather more intelligence as to where these hostages are being kept so that they can be stopped before they carry out these beheadings?
I don't think so. I don't think you can use that kind of surveillance to find a target as small as a person in a field or a safe house in a town. You're going to need human source intelligence and technical intelligence at the heart of ISIS. We're not going to resolve the hostage crisis by flying drones over an area. You've got to have penetrations on the ground to find this kind of stuff. And furthermore, the real problem with intelligence in this case is it's not good enough to know where they were yesterday. You've got to know where they are tomorrow. And that kind of intelligence is really tough to get.
If I could end with you, Colonel Francona, this does get to the deficiencies, though, of what is principally an air campaign without a ground presence, does it not?
Yes, it does. And I think we've been saying that for a long time. In Iraq, I think we've got a solution down the road. That will be the Iraqi army and the Peshmerga.
If they perform.
And right now, it's very frustrating to watch what's happening with the Iraqi army. In Syria, our game plan is still years away. I don't think it's a viable game plan to rely on the Free Syrian Army to take on ISIS when their real goal is to overthrow Bashar al-Assad. So I think the Syria portion is in real trouble. I think the Iraqi portion may have a chance.
Well, they even said it's going to take at least a year to train just 5,000 soldiers in Syria, which is not a lot considering
enterprise like ISIS. Yeah,
absolutely. Well, thanks very much, Rick Francona, General Hertling, as well as Phil Mudd. Out front next, more than a week after Thomas Duncan developed symptoms for Ebola, the contaminated bedding and towels have only just been removed today from his apartment complex. Why was this cleanup operation so late?